Hi there. I needed an envelope generator, so I built one. Let me introduce you to BUMS, a digital dual ADSR envelope generator with some tweaks. BUMS is 10 HP width and 2 cm deep. It has 2 ADSR sections, A and B. And each envelope comes with timing parameters, A, D, and R, and a sustain level on the slider. The timing parameters are additionally provided with a bump knob to control the curvature of each transition. Either linear, exponential, or logarithmic. The time phases span from 1 millisecond to 60 seconds per phase, which covers a wide range of use cases from super snappy clicks and bleeps to slowly evolving sound textures. Each envelope has 2 control voltage inputs, one for the bump of all time phases and a volt per octave input on the overall time tracking. The slider LED indicates positive output voltage at any time. The bottom rows provide the gate input, the end of cycle gate, and a normal and inverted output. Each envelope has a trigger button, which is a nice performance feature. They have a role in the calibration procedure as well, but we come to that later. Envelope B is normalized to envelope A. The normalization can be broken by patching the input gate of envelope B. So in this patch, we have gate A triggered together with gate B at the same time, as there's nothing patched into input gate B. The gate is created by my Dopfer A162 running at 50% duty cycle. Envelope A is effectively creating a rectangle as all time parameters are set to minimum. Envelope A is the CV input signal for the VCA, and this VCA's input is a low frequency sine from a filter set to full excitement. The VCA output is going straight to my mixer for recording. When lowering the sustain more and more, we end up with a super snappy direct kind of signal opening the VCA for an almost unhearable amount of time. Envelope B is feeding the FM input of the filter. When opening the attenuator of the FM input, we start to hear the pitch modulation of this envelope. Now we can play around with the decay time. But we can also leave the decay at a constant value and only change the curvature of the decay envelope. You can hear a significant difference in sound than just changing the time parameter. Alright, now let's see if we can find a patch that is a bit less tedious. In this patch, only envelope A is used, and I want to showcase some of the parameters based on a pre-built sequence. Let's add some kick for time reference. Start with attack time. Giving it some curvature. and putting it back. Now some decay. Some curvature. Adding some sustain. And add some release. You can build any envelope you can dream of. Sustain is very important to hold notes on a certain level and giving your sequence the ability to rest. In this patch we give it a go with two individual voices. Envelope A is volume and filter control for the bass voice and envelope B for the arpeggio. Again, I add some kick for timing reference. in dispatch, I quickly set up some granular sounds in ER301. And I have a single trigger from the clock divider, which is coming in every now and then. And I put a very slow attack phase. I give this more exponential curve now. So it even peaks more noticeably by the end. Add some decay. Release. I put a very long release now. There was the trigger again, so it's rising again on the attack. Stop the sequencer now, so there's no further trigger coming in. And release, fully closed. Another important use case for having the full control over the envelope's shape is when using it as a CV generator for your VCA sidechain. In this patch, two oscillators are summed into a VCA. Envelope B is getting a quarter gate from the clock divider, and the inverted output is sent to the VCA CV input. The signal is attenuated with this fellow guy here. First, I start to increase the ducking effect, and then I look for the shape that suits best to me. A bit too much. Maybe here. See how we can use the shape parameter to fit the ducking perfectly in. Bumps can also be used as a free-running LFO. I implemented a simple trick here. After each cycle, the EOC output is going high, thus triggering the envelope again. Next, the EOC is synchronized with the attack phase. So once the attack phase is over, EOC goes low again, switching the envelope directly to release phase. So when inserting a patch cable here, you effectively end up with an AR envelope. Use attack and release bump to give it some contour. You may have noticed that bumps can easily oscillate into audible ranges. Let's elaborate this in the following patch a bit further. Envelope B is patched to LFO mode and set to short attack and release times. Note how the tone varies with different bump contours. There's some lovely grittiness in some of those settings. And the volt per octave CV input makes the envelope B a playable oscillator. You can also create some fun effects sounds using a single bump that modulates itself. During the calibration procedure, the trigger button of envelope B can be used to exit the procedure at any time. This is why, as a first step, you need to plug in a patch cable into gate input B to break the normalization. Then switch off the case and turn it on again while holding the play button A for at least 2 seconds. The LED of slider A is starting to blink slowly. The module now waits for reference voltages at the 4 CV inputs. In this case, I generate the required voltages using Ornament and Crime and my Lynx buffered mult. In step 1, 1 volt is required. Now press play button A again. Slider B starts blinking slowly. Change the input voltage to 3 volt. After pressing play button A again, the module validates the values measured. In case one of the 8 values is outlying from certain ranges, the module would start blinking fast, signaling a calibration error. Please note, the module is not working with bad calibration data. If calibration values fit into predefined ranges, the module stores them into flash and signals successfully calibration with about 1.5 seconds fast blinking LEDs. Upon restart, a calibrated module automatically restores calibration data from flash and starts normal operation. But wait, there's one more thing. Let me introduce you to PAL. PAL is a companion module for bumps, providing the ability to visualize what is going on in the internal guts of the envelope generator. Originally created for debugging purposes, I decided to create this lightweight product for three reasons. First, it can be produced and offered very cheap. It is only that panel, the LCD module, and some screws that hold everything together. Second, it looks much better than a blank panel on its own. If there's some space left in your case, PAL might be an option. And third, it just looks nice and the envelope state animation is quite mesmerizing and inspiring when messing around. In the display, you see AD and R phase times and the amount of frequency modulation in yellow. The phase time colors correspond to the knob colors. And last but not least, PAL is helping me explaining what the bump CV is all about. Let me show you. Find an envelope solution on the market with the amount of freedom and individuality on envelope shaping I was looking for. So I picked the opportunity to have a try on the process on module creation, from vision to realization, and learning about development and production procedures, because that's what this channel is all about, right? Your feedback on the project is warmly appreciated. Let me know in the comments what you think, whether you like it or not, if you want to suggest improvements or whatever comes to your mind. I really appreciate any feedback. At this point, I cannot emphasize enough the importance and greatness of works by Emily Gillet from Mutable Instruments and Simon Kalweit from Westlicht, who open their sources to the public. Without these resources, I would never have been able to get an entry point for this kind of developments. So this goes out to you. Thank you. You're just great. Take care. Bye.